finding creatures on the ocean floor at night can be a little bit difficult. Unless, of course, you can do this. Whoa, look at them glow!
Many weird and wonderful sea creatures fluoresce at night, which basically means they absorb blue or ultraviolet light and re-radiate it in a visible part of the spectrum. But very little is understood about which sea creatures fluoresce or why.
What is that thing?
So in this video, we're on a mission to collect the evidence to answer these big questions. We'll be working our way from the shallows to the deep ocean where the most fluorescent species live, including our main target, the giant spearing mantis shrimp. But first, we need to do some testing. Okay guys, so we've got two lights to try today. The first one is this blue light, but the second one, which I'm really excited about, is the UV. Now, we can't actually see UV light, although if I shine it on my hand, you can see my fingertips glow a really funky color.
So we're gonna go and scour the shallows and try and find some stationary subjects like corals and anemones and see if we can get anything to glow. Let's do it. Okay, so here's this reef here. So this is what it looks like with normal white light. So I guess first things first, let's try the blue light. Nope, that's red. There we go. So we've got a little bit of fluorescence, but overall, this isn't really the sort of dazzling experience I was hoping for. So let's try the UV. Whoa, look at it. There's glowing corals everywhere. They're obviously full of fluorescing proteins. Look at the size of this one. Oh, that's awesome.
Interestingly, research suggests that blue light should trigger stronger fluorescence in most sea creatures. But without the right filters, the intense blue light can make it difficult to see the glow. UV light, however, isn't visible to us, so it doesn't overwhelm the scene, allowing the fluorescence to stand out more clearly. And in corals, it reveals some incredibly intricate patterns and colours.
So, like the anemones, these hard corals glow for a number of reasons. They do it in part to protect themselves from UV radiation in the shallow water, but supposedly it also helps them attract the algae that they use for photosynthesis. And not only that, but it might make the conditions for photosynthesis even better.
Corals will also secrete a mucus when stressed, and it turns out this fluoresces too.
Whoa, and look at this coral. It's even, I don't know, there's some sort of vapor coming off it like a slime, and even that's fluorescing.
Corals fluoresce thanks to special proteins inside their tissues called fluorescent proteins that absorb ultraviolet light and re-emit it as visible light. However, different proteins in the corals emit different colours. Some glow green, others might glow red or blue or orange, and some glow many different colours. In addition, many different types of corals exhibit fluorescence, including hard corals like acropora and brain corals, as well as soft corals and encrusting corals. But whilst capturing this footage, it dawned on me that perhaps these corals were also fluorescing to attract food.
So one thing that's really interesting is how all of this plankton is also attracted to the UV lights. And it's literally everywhere, look, including in my ears.
And the corals were definitely making the most of an easy meal.
This coral seems to be catching all of this plankton. I'm not sure whether it's feeding on it or what, but there's all sorts of strange plankton now stuck in it.
Contrary to popular belief, corals are actually animals, and many of them feed on plankton that they catch in their polyps' tentacles as it drifts through the water. It's possible that these corals make use of fluorescence to draw in more prey. But it's not just sea creatures that glow under UV.
Check this out. Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
This here is a carpet anemone with a few saddleback cuttlefish in it. So currently we've got some white light on it, but watch what happens when I take that away. Look at that, that is some crazy glowing there. The anemone is glowing a bright green color.
Like the corals, the anemones fluoresce for protection, as well as to attract the symbiotic algae that photosynthesize within their tissues. However, some seem to fluoresce very differently. Another carpet anemone we found just had a few fluorescent patches, and these small burrowing anemones display a much more regular and intricate fluorescent pattern. Anemones can also consume much bigger prey than most corals, including fish, and it's possible that fluorescing also makes them more effective hunters. Luckily though, the resident saddleback clownfish that reside in this big anemone offer a cleaning and protection service, so they are safe. So safe in fact that these ones have decided to lay some eggs.
You can see how the anemone is clearly fluorescing, but the eggs that are down here are not fluorescing at all. which kind of makes sense given I'm sure the clownfish don't want to make them super visible. There's also lots of little shrimps down here that are also fluorescing a sort of light blue colour.
But much bigger crustaceans lurk on the ocean floor here, and some of them have some serious weaponry.
So this here is the spear of a big spearing Lisa's mantis. Blimey, I'm being covered in small fish. This is one of the creatures that we're going to be looking for in the deep ocean. So fingers crossed we can find it and see if it glows. I'm being assaulted. Oh, they're in my hair.
Right, guys. So we found the corals, we found the anemones, and they were glowing super brightly. But now we're going to go and try and find some moving targets. So we've got fish on the hit list and crustaceans. In particular, we're looking for the giant Lisa's mantis, but it lives really deep.
On our way down to the deep reef, I spotted the faint glow of another super interesting creature lying on the sand.
Oh my word, guys, look at this. A big broad club cuttlefish. Oh, he's glowing so nicely. That is absolutely awesome. And now he knows he's been spotted. Off he goes.
But the cuttlefish wasn't the only thing glowing on the sandy bottom, and I soon spotted a few pairs of eyes in the distance.
Here's a big stingray. Some very fluorescent eyeballs. What about his tail? Yeah, a little bit on those spines, but mainly just the eyeballs. So interestingly, scientists think that fluorescence in fish is usually in smaller fish, and that's because they communicate over smaller distances, which would explain why this big blue-spotted stingray isn't super fluorescent. I better stay away from that barbed tail, though.
And the stingrays weren't the only glowing reef fish, although some seem to fluoresce in much more unusual places.
This puffer's just got some crazy fluorescent eyebrows. I'm not sure why they need to fluoresce, but I'm sure he's got his reasons. Nice style, mate. These guys will probably fluoresce, but I hate them, so I'm not even gonna try. Whoa, big cornet fish. He doesn't seem to want to glow, though, unfortunately. Oh, his back little dorsal fin does, though. That's cool.
It wasn't until we got to the deep reef that we got to really appreciate the sheer diversity of fluorescence in reef fish. Although it definitely made some species look incredibly demonic.
What is that thing? Oh, it's a cowfish with some crazy fluorescent eyes.
This is a longhorn cowfish, a poisonous reef fish armed with some long robust horns on its face and its butt that it uses for defense. Now, you definitely don't want to get charged by one of these, but unfortunately, like a lot of fish, they're overly curious of big reflective camera lenses. However, it soon became clear that not all fish fluoresce, and for good reason.
You can see all these little damselfishes hiding inside this acropora, and these guys aren't glowing at all, which for a small reef fish that likes to stay hidden at night, that seems to make sense. And this little surgeon fish here is just doing his best to stay hidden.
But it wasn't until we zoomed in a little that we really appreciated the sheer number of smaller fish that glow in the dark. Especially the venomous scorpion fishes.
So the fish, like this big scorpion fish here, supposedly use fluorescence for communication. And the communication might be positive, so they might use it to help them find mates, or negative, and that they might be using it to signal to competitors to stay away from them. It's possible as well that they're using it, of course, to attract prey, and we've seen that with this one. When the UV lights are on, all the little fish come and swim near his mouth, and boom! He goes and grabs them. He is lightning fast.
Although this one got so carried away that its eyes got a little bit too big for its stomach. And of course, my favourite fish also wanted in on the action. So, the reason that fluorescence for communication is much more effective in smaller fish is because the emitted light doesn't travel very far in water due to scattering. This theory was evidenced by a much smaller scorpion fish that was glowing a neon blue colour from his little perch within the corals, as well as by the bright yellow and pink colours of other tiny reef fish that were drifting along the sandy bottom. But while swimming over the reef, I'd occasionally catch glimpses of a bright yellow tail sliding between the rocks, and after countless hours of searching, I eventually caught the culprit emerging from a burrow in the sand. I believe this is a fimbriated moray eel, and this was one of my favourite glowing creatures we found. This neon yellow fluorescence appears to be quite unusual, likely due to the presence of a specific type of fluorescent protein that's not found in many other reef fish. Unlike the scorpionfish, the moray seemed a little distressed at first by the sheer amount of plankton that was swarming his burrow. After some time, he also ventured out onto the sand, and this gave us the perfect opportunity to document the insane colour transformation that occurs when these small morays are exposed to UV.
So this is what this eel looks like under normal white light, and here's what he looks like under UV. Whoa, that is gonna be the best one yet.
But we still hadn't found our main target, the giant spearing mantis shrimp. We were going to have to go much deeper. Now, another really interesting observation we made whilst filming this video is that unlike the fish, corals and anemones, almost all crustaceans seem to fluoresce, from the smallest shrimps to the biggest crabs.
Look at the size of that crab. I wonder if this guy fluoresces. Whoa, look at that. He's fluoresced this crazy sort of white, greeny color. And there's also all these shrimps and planktons running around him. But this guy's massive, look, there's my hand. Oh, better be careful actually, in case he decides to nip me. Yeah, that's a big old crab.
But, unlike this big reef crab that relies on burying himself in the sand, other glowing crabs have developed much more interesting methods for staying hidden.
Whoa, so this is a crazy creature. This here is a decorator crab. And it's basically a crab that sticks all sorts of sort of rubble and other organic matter to its shell in order to camouflage itself against this rubbly bottom. Let me pick him up so you can see, just for contrast. There he is, look. The decorator crab, and look at him glow underneath this UV light. But yeah, you would not see him at all. These UV lights definitely help, but he's very well camouflaged.
One of the best things about using UV lights at night is that it uncovers critters that would normally be impossible to spot.
Whoa, sea spider! Just here, look. This is one super creepy critter, this is.
Whilst these sea spiders share some similar characteristics with their terrestrial cousins, like having eight legs, for example, they're not closely related. They also have one of the most bizarre anatomical features in the animal kingdom, in that lots of their organs, including their digestive system, are found in their long, spindly legs. Sea spiders are predatory scavengers with an appetite for invertebrates, like anemones, and they feed by injecting a needle-like proboscis into the soft tissues of their prey and sucking out the juices. They also come in different shapes and sizes, and it wasn't long before we found another one with shorter but much more furry legs. This one was only a few centimeters across, but in the deep ocean, giant species exist, and they can be over a meter long. However, the sea spiders weren't the only bright blue crustaceans patrolling the sandy bottom. These hermit crabs, with their thick furry legs, also fluoresced a fantastic blue colour. Although, again, some were much bluer than others, and much more camera shy. But not all crustaceans fluoresce so strongly. This little slipper or locust lobster was much more difficult to spot as it sat amongst the rocks on the ocean floor.
Oh, look at this slipper lobster!
So far, this experiment had been a real success. We'd managed to expose some incredible fluorescence in a wide variety of sea creatures, from corals and anemones to cuttlefish, big reef predators and creepy crustaceans, and we'd better understood what fluoresces and why. But there was still one thing left to find. And as we scoured the sandy depths, something lit up in the distance.
Oh, is that what I think it is? Oh, it is! It's the giant spearing mantis, the Lisa's mantis! We found one! Oh, and look at it glow! That is amazing!
We also got the chance to test out some different wavelengths of UV on another big Lisa's mantis that was close by, and you can see how this affects the colour of the emitted light. This one was bright green.
So guys, this here is a big Lisa's mantis shrimp under normal white light. Here's what it looks like under UV. Whoa, look at it. It's glowing bright green. He's disappeared down his little hole. And on that note, I'll see you next time.
Guys, thanks so much for watching. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you're in the mood for more, make sure to check out one of these videos.